RPG Chick here with another awesome death-defying episode of Let's Play the Whispered World Blind. We're about to enter the factory, which I didn't know was a factory. Now that we've got it going again because we stole the one pearl missing from Ruben's collection, he's having Bando! Fire up the factory to make one more pearl. God forbid we wake up Kalita. He's so worried about that happening. Oh, there's more to the factory. Awesome. I was like, this little room is the factory? Now that we've got things running, let's see how things look.
A wheel. What could it be for?
Why, for opening that trap door.
No. That is not a toothed wheel.
Ha! My God, get a hold of yourself.
I see.
It just opened up again anyway. So we've got all the displays. These are actually meters, not... I don't think of them as displays. I was thinking like video or something.
The data on the display is pretty disturbing. Not that I understand, but not understanding the data doesn't make it less disturbing.
Okay.
I'd better ask somebody who knows these things. Even better, I'd ignore them and focus on my task.
Huh.
I shouldn't mess around with things I know nothing about, which means I should reduce my messing around in general. Data on the display that I would not.
They should have him say different things.
I'd better ask somebody who knows. Even better. I shouldn't mess around. Which means.
Because. Which one did we even look at? The bottom one, I guess? I guess they all say the same thing. Oh, broken cogwheel. This is the other half of the cogwheel that we need.
It's broken right through the middle. Everything is breaking down. There are some teeth missing here, but I'm still using mine for grinding mostly.
You old porn hound, you. Take that. Molding press, okay.
That's a molding press. I think it's used to make pearls. That's just a guess.
Wait, can we go down in? I guess so.
It's a little too big to make mucus balls.
Ugh.
No, no, no. That's not how the molding press is operated. If I made a guess, I'd say it's this big wheel on that side there.
Yep.
There's another room down there. I should be careful not to fall down. I could break my spine. Hello? Is somebody down there? No answer. But I can hear Bando shoveling.
Yeah, you gotta yell loud for him. He works in yells, you know, so.
I can't climb down there without any means. I'll break every bone in my body.
Oh, we have a ladder, though. Oh, we have to take it back from... Okay.
It's broken. Yuck. No.
No. Alright, we have to go get that ladder so we can go down further, and I know what to do with the cogwheel, definitely. We have the other half in a vise. On the second room of a Bando's shack. Get the ladder. I said get the ladder. Thank you. Kinda wish he had a run speed right now. Doop 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 doop. Come on, Sadwick. In you go. Hopefully this thing doesn't burst into flames. How did Bando get down there anyway? Hi! How you doing? All this just for one pearl? Ventilators.
Despite the ventilator, it's pretty hot down here. Ah, a breath of fresh air. With an interesting aftertaste of rust, lead, and soot.
Mm-hmm.
That'll have to wait for now. After I've prevented the world from ending, I should have plenty of time to put my hand between fast rotating metal discs. Despite the ventilator.
I am assuming they all said well, I didn't mean to do that.
Despite the ventilator.
I'm gonna just space it off of.
Spike of it.
Okay.
It's hardly anything more fascinating than big fireplaces. How merrily the flames dance, devouring everything while crackling cheerfully in the process. Wow.
I guess they didn't want to type that all out.
If you listen closely, you can hear voices in the crackling of the flames. They call out to me.
I want you to jump in.
This is the perfect place to warm one's hand. Or to get blisters, even. I'm proud of me. I've made a human being very happy today. He even cried tears of happiness. I'd better get off his back. He already got into enough trouble because of me. I don't want to get between him and his work. He'd accidentally shovel me into the stove and not even notice.
Okay. Guess we'll leave the ladder there for now. We need to go up to Bando's shack. Cogwheel. In there. Awesome.
The cogwheel is broken and useless, a bit like me. The cogwheel is a bit. My head feels like it.
Yeah. So I think we have to fuse this like this. Guessing. Awesome. That melted pretty quickly. So we have a full cogwheel now.
There aren't many occasions when I can say this, but good boy, Spot. I just repaired the cogwheel.
Spot repaired the cogwheel. Okay, so.
Well, let's have a go at it then.
Just click anywhere. Where is it supposed to go? Ah. Oh, we got a different hand here. All right, let's try that. Oh, sorry. Keep forgetting, you had to just click once on things.
At least something is moving now, but there's something wrong with those cogwheels.
Oh, we gotta move them all around? Lever! Thank you. No, I don't think they would make contact there, but.
It is something.
Alright, let me take a look at this. Without you in the way, we got fixture. I mean, I don't want to move all of them, do I? Try it here. Well, doesn't want to go there. That doesn't look right, does it? Well, can you even take that one off? Oh boy. It still doesn't look like we have enough cogwheels. I mean, I hope we do. I doubt this will work.
At least something is moving now, as I said.
We can't remove that one. So matter what we do here, we can't have this cogwheel come in context. I know the teethies are supposed to go together. Well, that looks right, doesn't it?
At least something is moving now. Is there something? At least something that I sent.
We need a tiny one in between, don't we? Aha! Maybe this is just a place. This is a place to keep the spare cogwheels. Aha!
Wow, I've made it.
Awesome.
I did that very well for a change. I'm not that clumsy after all.
It's a bit of trial and error.
It has enough teeth already. No, I've already repaired that.
Okay.
My head feels like it.
Yeah, let's go. Hello. Oh my god, all the candles. I'm not looking at all of them.
I like candlelight. It reminds me of my mother's grave.
Uh-huh. And he won't take them because...
I'd better leave it here. It reminds me of my mother's grave.
Let's make sure one of these things are on candles, so there's a barrel there. And that goes in the cabin.
That's a barrel. Nothing more. Yeah, right. Yummy. Rainwater. Yum.
Yum.
Empty.
I thought there was rainwater.
A cabin. I wonder who lives here. I'd better find out if somebody's home first.
Oh, whatever. Oh, a signpost. Missed it among all the candles. Barrel, candles. Candles. I just want to make sure there's no item laying around. Check out the signpost.
No trespassing. No admittance. Step no further. Prohibited area. Keep out. Yucky territory.
Abandon all hope, ye who enter here.
No trespassing. No step. Prohib yucky.
Well, let's take it.
I'd better leave the signs where they are. Somebody must want them standing here.
Alright, let's go in the cabin. Cabin in the woods!
Hello?
Ah, come on in.
Oh,
come on in.
You're the one from the shore. This is the one, Mulachei. He's the one from the shore when we first landed, so to speak, on this island. Before we talk to him, of course, we'll look at everything. It's just how we roll.
Mulachei seems to have only the bare necessities in his kitchen. No better than Grandpa's kitchen, which is only filled with non-necessities. Can I try some of this?
No. There is only enough for myself. I hardly ever have visitors.
Do you ever wonder why?
Yeah, because it's very hard to get to you.
Can I have one of your glasses?
I'm afraid not. I don't have many possessions. There's nothing here I couldn't do without.
I think you're just greedy.
Mulachei seems no bit.
Same with this jar, huh?
Can I try some?
No, I hardly.
Do you ever wonder? Can I have?
I'm afraid I don't. There's nothing.
Alright, pots?
Mulachei no better.
Kidding me.
Can I have some of your pots?
I'm afraid not. I don't have many possessions. There's nothing here I couldn't do without.
Can I try some?
No. I hide.
Do you ever wonder?
Do you ever wonder why? See what happens. This pot.
Mulachei. No bit.
Same candle. Because we're not going to want to take it.
That's one of Mulachai's candles. It hasn't been used yet. Can I borrow that candle?
Yes. Be my guest. Everyone needs a light to guide him through the dark.
And it is quite dark now.
Okay. Well, at least we got a candle from him.
The candle isn't burning anymore. Extinguished.
It never was. You told me that he never used that.
It reminds me of that terrible, terrible skit Grandpa used to perform. It involved a baton, a candle, and magnesium powder. Although I was just 4 at the time, I still knew how embarrassing it was.
Yeah. Wait, hold on a second. Ah! Didn't mean to do that, sorry. So pots, jars, bed. Mulachei, and out.
It looks pretty comfy for the bed of a hermit.
I wonder how it doesn't collapse.
Why aren't you sleeping at this time of night?
This puzzle doesn't let me rest. I keep asking myself if there's anything I'm missing. Are you tired, little man?
Not really. I suffer from severe insomnia.
So why do you tinker with my bed?
All right, I'll stop it.
Sorry, guys. Apparently the mic was a little farther away from my mouth. I just realized that.
He's lost in his puzzle. I don't want to disturb him. He wants to be alone. I can sure understand that.
Yet we have no problem asking him all these questions. Nice place you got here.
Nice place you've got here.
Thank you. I like living alone.
Oh, I can certainly understand that.
Loneliness is a real blessing.
I totally agree. But you seem to repeat yourself.
He didn't. He said he likes it, and then he said it's a blessing. It's a little different. What's with all the candles?
What's with all the candles?
It is my attempt to maintain the equilibrium of the island. All things are intertwined. The candlelight keeps away the five yakis that live on this island. It is said that if they meet with the other five in the dark, they'll begin migrating.
The other five?
Yes, that's what's been told. Then they will cross the island together until they reach the pier, where they will sing their woeful song. Their song would
Kalida,
wake Kalida, they say, which would have terrible consequences. That's why I make sure the candles are not blown out by the wind.
So the candles prevent the yakis from waking Kalida?
Essentially, yes.
And we've been blowing them out this whole time, but I guess he's been relighting them. What do you think about Reuben?
What do you think about Reuben?
He's a fool. He thinks he can maintain the status quo by staying completely inactive.
That seems like a good strategy.
It is erroneous thinking. Nothing is immobile. All things are in motion. And that's how it should be.
You wouldn't say that if you knew what I know. Nothing.
I'd like to talk with you about Kalida.
I'd like to talk to you about Kalida.
What do you want to know?
Everything. What did you mean the other time?
What did you mean the other time? I have found Kalida. I am part of her now.
I meant it the way I said it.
Arrogant and imprecise, then.
If that was your impression.
Oh.
I plan to wake Kalida.
I plan to wake Kalida.
That would be very foolish.
That's all? It would be foolish? Is there a reason to go along with that, perhaps?
None that you would like.
None that you would like, he says. One more question. Would I like the reason less than getting no answer at all? It's just that I can hardly believe it.
You are full of questions. And as long as you refuse to accept the answers, it will stay that way forever.
That is actually very wise words. Although, is it really asking too much to get a clear answer for once?
Is it really asking too much to get a clear answer for once?
Maybe you're not asking the right question.
Oh, how about when would you stop dancing around the issues? Enough of Kalida.
As you wish.
What was that about the Yakis again?
What was that about the Yakis again?
There are exactly five of them. If they meet with the other five in the dark, they'll begin migrating. Then they will cross the island together until they reach the pier, where they will sing their woeful song. Their song would wake Kalida, they say, which would have terrible consequences. That's why I make sure the candles are not blown out by the wind.
Would you mind leaving the candles alone?
Would you mind leaving the candles alone?
No.
No? Oh, come on. It's important. We could all die.
Only stagnation means death. Remember that. There's no balance without movement.
Aw, man. That's just balderdash. I'm talking about a real threat.
It is not balderdash. It is rather one of nature's laws. No balance without movement. It's like in this chess game here.
And how about I prove you wrong?
I told you that's impossible. So, what are you going to prove?
That it's possible. So he's playing chess? I thought he had like a puzzle or something. What are you playing?
What are you playing?
It's a puzzle.
Oh, a puzzle. Maybe I can help you. I'm good at puzzles. What's the deal? Is it some kind of checkers?
No, the problem is more of a philosophical nature. And it's instructive. The puzzle teaches us that it's impossible to create quintessential balance. All things must remain in motion.
Oh, yeah? We'll see about that.
Oh, yeah? We'll see about that.
You may as well try, but it's no use.
Okay. What do I have to do?
The queens can move horizontally, vertically, and diagonally, like in a game of chess. For completion, they must each be positioned in such a fashion that they cannot take each other out. But don't bother. Equilibrium without movement. Such a thing is impossible.
Well, let's have a try then.
I'm no good at chess, guys. I mean, I don't even know which pieces these are. I mean, that's the queen there. Are they all queens? Why can't I take the other queen? See that? I have no idea what I'm doing, guys. In case you haven't noticed. Ta-da! There you go. All done. How's it supposed to work again?
How is it supposed to work again? Okay. What do I have to do?
The queens can move horizontally, vertically, and diagonally, like in a game of chess. For completion, they must each be positioned in such a fashion that they cannot take each other out. But don't bother. Equilibrium without movement. Such a thing is impossible.
Well, let's have a try then.
I really don't want to do this.
That's too complicated for me.
Complicated? That is pure understatement. It is unsolvable. That is the fascinating thing about it.
Well, see you later.
See you later.
I'm not messing with that. I might have to go look at a walkthrough to see if there's a way to solve that. Let's go this way now. Let's see the fact that they're all queens. Forest. Oh, there's the Yakis.
Pretty dark there, except for the shining eyes of voracious predators. Hello, voracious predators. I am here. Wait a second. Maybe that wasn't very clever. Why did I do it in the first place?
Meat that announces itself.
It's hardly the right time for collecting wood in the forest. I could interrupt voracious predators preying on unwary wanderers.
Yeah, you know, they need to eat, so.
Mulachei said something about 5 Yakis. Where might the other 2 be?
Hanging out somewhere?
I don't want to scare them away. If they hide any deeper in the woods, they won't be able to help me find Kalita. I should make them come to the opposite shore with me. But how? I don't want to scare them away. I should not.
What if I blow out all these candles? Maybe then they'll come out? That. I definitely hear them. Oh, wait, wait. Here. Maybe they'll come with me now?
I don't want to scare them. If they hide, I should not. Look here, Spot. I found new playmates for you. They don't seem to care for you. You're such a bore.
Hey, you didn't meet our Pat. Spot.
Hush, Spot. Mulachei wants to be left alone.
Yeah. Okay. Well, thanks for watching, everyone. Tune back next time when I figure something out. Bang, bang, boogie, and don't stop the boogie.